and one weekend only, the BUHS Music Department proudly presents our 2024 musical, Mamma Mia! Student choreographers. We truly appreciate the work of Diana Webb, who choreographed Leo, Your Love, and Does Your Mother Know? Next, in order to preserve the safety of the secret island idol, please remember to keep all aisles clear and turn off recording devices. Also, to ensure that our wireless microphone system works properly, please put all cell phones and mobile devices into airplane mode. And in spite of Sky's efforts to get the Taverna online, emailed, wired up, and knuckled down, it is against the local custom of the islands to take unauthorized recordings or photos. Between acts, we will take a 15-minute intermission. Should you need the restroom at that time, the facilities are located on the first floor near the main lobby. When you return, please remember that there is no food or drink permitted in the auditorium. In the event of an emergency, please calmly exit the theater through the rear doors and down the stairs. At the end of the show, should you wish to recycle your program, there will be a box at the rear of the theater in which to place your program. Thank you, and enjoy the show!
Thank you.
Good luck. Sophie?
Sophie!
Sophie! Oh my God!
Where's
Sophie, Allie, Lisa, we're the best girls in the place. Whenever we're together, there's a smile on your face!
Oh my God, where have you been? I thought you'd get here hours ago.
What a journey. Guess who left her ticket on the kitchen
table? Oh my God!
She said we have to get on this plane.
It's our best friend's wedding tomorrow.
You made such a fuss. You weren't getting married without your bridesmaid.
Oh.
So, where is he then?
Your Sky! We're dying to meet him!
How's Donna?
I bet she's going nuts for this wedding.
I've been dying for you two to get here.
I've got a secret. You're the only ones I can tell.
Oh God.
You're pregnant.
I don't.
I've invited my dad to my wedding.
Your dad?
You mean you finally found him?
Not exactly.
Look, I found this in Mom's desk drawer.
Sophie, you're not supposed to go around reading your mom's diary.
No, but she's supposed to go around reading yours.
But look, 1979. It's the one she kept the year she got pregnant with me.
You know how she won't talk about my dad? Says she can't remember?
Mm-hmm.
But listen, July 17th.
What a night!
After the show, Sam rode me over to the little island. We danced on the beach, and kissed on the beach, and dot, dot, dot.
What?
Dot, dot, dot. That's what they did in the old days. Sam's the one. I know he is. I've never felt like this before. Frightening them off before I've gotten a chance to know them.
With any luck, I'll know my dad straight away.
And what if you don't?
Then I've got 24 hours to find out!
I'm Money, money, money must be funny in a rich man's world. Money, 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 always sunny in a rich man's world.
Deanna, but the point is that that is my taverna. I built it. Well, no, I designed it. I drew up the plans 20 years ago. Can't believe she actually went and built the damn thing.
Who?
Donna. Who else? This is something I scribbled on the back of a napkin.
So how do you know it's yours?
Well, buildings are like babies. You always know your own.
I wouldn't know very much about babies. I've been living out of a backpack my whole life.
The happy wanderer, eh? Do you think the island will inspire some prose?
I certainly hope so. When I got that wedding invite, I sold my editor a copy of Childhood Haunts, Revisited.
Oh, were you born here?
No, I was born in the U.S., but my mother's Greek. I actually did come to Greece once to visit my great aunt on the mainland. That was 21 years ago.
Ah, but now you can write about Sam's taverna and the tourists will flock.
No, I think I'd like this island to remain the secret idol I've always remembered it as.
Oh, yes, but if you wrote about it, maybe that idol could be the boatload of tourists with the big bucks.
I mean, at least they'd have some staff here. I mean, where is everyone?
Oh, good afternoon. Can I help you?
Hey, I'm Bill Austin. You have a room for me?
Bill Austin?
And I'm Wright. Harry Wright.
Harry. So you must be...
Sam Carmichael. You're expecting us.
Yeah, I'll go and I'll get the keys.
Oh, charming. Well, I hope I get the chance to get my tongue around a little Greek. I haven't spoken the language.
21 years.
21 years. Now that is interesting. Hey, Bill, here's a story for you. Three men, strangers, are invited to an island for a wedding by a woman they haven't seen in 21 years. Why are they here?
That's not bad. All right, Harry, spill. What's torn you from the Bank of England?
Is this an interview? Well, all right, well, for me, it was Donna's letter that brought back many happy memories. Oh, bloody Nora!
Is that a quote?
No, no, I know this guitar. Look here, HB, headbanger. That's what they used to call me in those days. And DS, Donna Sheridan. I bought this for her. Cost me 10 quid in my Johnny Rotten t-shirt. So now who says I'm an unadventurous old stick in the mud? My other half. I mean, a big house, a fast car, and a season ticket to the Chelsea Football Club isn't enough for some people, is it? No, they want the Great White Hunter too. Well, I can do spontaneity. That's why I'm here. Donna knew my wild side. I was an exchange student in Paris when we met, and I just followed her to Greece spontaneously. Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Used to sing this one. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty. What would life be without a song or a dance? What are
Donna's daughter.
Yeah.
Wow.
Now I knew you looked familiar. Sophie. Sophia.
It's just Sophie.
No, Sophia's the Greek. I had a great aunt, Sophia.
I'm named after her, Sophia.
Where is Donna? I want to see her and thank her for the invitation.
Oh, yes, it's very kind of her to remember us.
No, you can't. You're a secret. I sent the invitations. Mom doesn't know.
But why?
Oh, well, Mom's always talking about her friends from the old days, and I figured she'd be thrilled if I invited you all. But she's got herself in such a state about this wedding. Mention unexpected guests, and she'll hyperventilate.
Hang on, Sophie, am I getting this? Donna doesn't know I'm here?
No, she doesn't. So pretend you're here on a spontaneous holiday. She'll get a lovely surprise when she sees you at my wedding, and we can let her in on the secret.
But Sophie!
Mother says I was a dancer before I could walk.
Boy, you have made a mistake.
She says I began to sing long before I could talk. But I've often wondered, how did it all start?
I wanna sing it out to you. Mamma mia. whole open press would say about my outfit.
Hey, we should do a number tonight for Sophie's party.
I can wear this as an eye patch.
Poor Sophie.
Haven't seen her. Why?
I must find her now.
Ta-da!
What the hell's all that about?
We found it in the trunk. You should hang up in the basket so we would have funky mom she's got.
No, get rid of it. Burn it. I never want to see it again.
What's wrong? What happened?
I thought it was over. Past, I'd almost forgotten, but it isn't.
What isn't?
Nothing. Never mind, I can't talk about it. But I knew this would happen. All my life it's been tapping at my shoulder. Of course it had to come out now. I had to... God, why was I such a stupid little idiot?
Chiquitita, tell me what's wrong.
Muscled out.
circulation.
You're safe tonight. It is a male free zone at Sophie's party. And tomorrow, Tanya and I will take them fishing.
Fishing?
Oh, please. What do you expect us to do with three men?
Oh, now that takes me back.
Donna, you should have told us. I remember when I lost it.
He was a hot slice of beef.
Rosaline at the Orpheus Bar, and strippers at Medusa's, and Pepper's bringing his handcuffs.
Don't go.
And miss out on my last night of freedom.
No, I don't mean don't go. I mean, well, is that really how you see it?
I mean, yeah. No. I see it as last night for the greatest adventure of our lives. Come here.
Hey, Sky. You know how I said I wanted to find my dad?
Sophie, we've been over this. You don't need your dad. I'm here.
Yeah, I know. But, Sky, no matter what happens, you'll never leave me, right?
Leave you? Are you crazy? You've turned my world upside down.
I love you, Dad. Thank you.
someday. Your mom beat me to it.
Do you always prefer buildings to people?
What?
Tell me something about my mom.
Your mom? Well, she was irresistible. We talked and we fought and we... You know, it was me who brought her to this island.
That wasn't the only thing you did, was it?
Alright, what has she told you?
Well, nothing. She's never mentioned you.
But Sophie, you said your mom was always talking about her friends from the old days. Sophie, what is it? Why am I here? Sophie!
Thank you.
I think it's great.
Sam?
I've always wanted a little girl, and, well, big one's not even, is even better.
No,
you
don't understand.
Oh, no, listen, I know I'm rushing things. Does your mother know that I know?
No, she can't.
Of course. Listen, who's giving you away?
Yeah.
Mom. Of course you're not okay. You're sleepwalking again.
Again? When do I ever sleepwalk?
The night you came down with the measles, the time you didn't finish your pines.
Mom, get off! Not a baby!
I know, so, but you're my daughter and I can tell that something's wrong. It's not too late. It can be fixed. I can sort out these wedding shenanigans.
Shenanigans? What do you mean, shenanigans?
I'm sorry, it's just a figure of speech.
No. That's what you think, isn't it? That I'm stupid to get married. It's just a whim.
I'm not pretending that I really understand.
Of course you don't. You never did the marriage and babies thing. You just did the baby.
What the hell is going on here? Why are you coming down on me?
I'm gonna do it right, Mom. I love Sky, and I want to be with him, and I don't want my kids growing up not knowing who their father is because it's crap!
Jesus, will you stop that racket before you wake the entire island? Eddie, where did you get that monstrosity?
Oh, he's not so bad.
Hey!
No, I found these babies in the cellar, just what we need for a wedding. Are they yours, Donna?
No, they're... And what sort of wedding do you think there's going to be with the state of the three of you, Sky? I'm not letting you marry my daughter smelling like a frat house. Hit the tub. And where do you think you're going?
I'm gonna scrub his back.
Oh, no, you're not. I need the champagne on ice, the ouzo in the punch bowls, lay out the tablecloths, the cutlery, the best glasses. They'll have to be washed and polished first. Eddie? Get your boat out.
Why?
Because my guests want to dive down to the old wreck to look for more pearl necklaces.
But Donna, we planted the one Sky found last night.
I don't care. It'll keep them busy till the wedding starts. For God's sakes, just do it!
Donna! What's the rush?
Small matter of a wedding.
Oh, yes. Well, about the wedding, you kept my bagpipes.
They scare off unwanted visitors.
Ooh, you do not need bagpipes to do that.
I wouldn't. My bite's worse than my bark.
Yeah, I know. I've got the scars. You wanna see them?
What are you doing here, Sam?
I had an idea for an extension.
I don't want your stupid extension. What are you doing here?
You're living my dream. Remember the island, the taverna? It's my dream.
Well, it's my reality. Hard work and a crippling mortgage.
Would you like me to take a look at that roof? I don't think it will last through the winter.
I'll fix my own goddamn roof.
Okay, fine. Be a martyr. I've got kids. I know how hard it is doing it on your own.
Oh no, you don't patronize me. I love doing it on my own. Every morning, I wake up and thank Christ I haven't got some middle-aged menopausal man to bother me. I'm single. I'm free and it's great.
Where are those happy days? They seem so hard to find. I try to reach for you, but you have closed your mind. Our love, it used to be so good.
taste of this, see if it tickles your taste buds.
Yes, but will it cure my hangover?
You should look in the mirror. You've just cured mine.
Down, boy! I'm old enough to be your mother.
Well, you could call me Oedipus.
Oh, Harry!
What time is it? Shouldn't you be getting ready?
Oh, don't worry about me, Harry. I've got loads of time. There's nothing worse than sitting around in your pantyhose for hours.
Donna must be tearing her hair out, you know, doing this whole wedding on her own. What would the bride's father do?
Well, normally he'd pay. Though in my case, my dad cut me off at my third.
Did he say anything beforehand? You know, words of advice, that sort of thing.
Yes. You see, there I'd be, standing in my cupcake dress, all ready to trip down the aisle. And he'd lean over and whisper, "Don't worry, doll. I know a good boy." Why are we talking about my dad?
I think I'm gonna go inside. Too much sun.
Oh, Harry, please don't go.
Let's catch up later.
And Tanya, why don't we catch up from last night?
I've thrown a veil over last night. Last night never happened.
Pepper, chop chop, champagne cocktails all around.
If you look behind you, you'll see the bar, and I'm sure you can help yourself.
You have to. We're guests now.
You just can't find good help these days.
Is that all you caught?
You should have seen the one that got away.
This big.
Bill, don't exaggerate. It was this big.
Drink, Bill?
Thanks, but no thanks. See, Rosie's promised me the works.
I have?
You know I always keep a copy of your Whole Woman cookbook in my backpack.
Well then, you'll know how to pepper my snapper.
Oh my God, look at the time, girls! It's time to get to work.
Work?
On my face, honey.
Little repair, renovation.
Well, I mean, you shouldn't mess with a masterpiece.
He is so tragic.
All left, no service.
Just ignore him, Tanya. He can't help being a jerk.
Tanya can't ignore the chemistry between us.
Little boys who play with fire get their finger burned.
Thank you.
each other.
It's all gone wrong anyway. Skylark, you've got to help me.
Why? What's wrong?
It's a mess and it's all my fault. I know I shouldn't have, but my red mom's diary. I've got 3 possible dads.
Oh my god.
I invited them to the wedding, and I thought I knew who my father was as soon as I saw him. But I didn't. And now all 3 think they're my dad, and they're all expecting to give me away.
Wait a minute. Go back. You did what?
I invited my dads to our wedding. It was 3 months ago. I wasn't even sure they'd come. God help me.
Why didn't you tell me? I thought we talked about everything. I thought we had trust, but you went behind my back for what? Some stranger?
No, Sky, it wasn't like that.
Is this what this big white wedding's for? A setup so you can find your dad?
No, it's not that at all.
I wanted to take a boat to the mainland and get married with a couple of witnesses, but you insisted on this big white wedding so you could find your dad and play happy little
families? It's not who I am.
That doesn't come from your dad, Sophie. That comes from you. I was marrying you because I loved you, and I thought that's what you wanted. But I don't know anymore.
You don't know if you love me?
I don't know if that's what you want.
I'm sorry. I'm interrupting.
Listen, you think about it.
No, but Sky, wait!
Wait, Sophie! Wait, let him go. He's right. You have to know that's what you really want.
Got nothing to do with you!
I'm your dad! I can't give you away unless I know that you're really happy.
Well, I've had this conversation with my mother. She knows me a lot better than you do.
Oh, what does Donna the Dynamo know about marriage or divorce? Listen, I've got 20 years of good advice to cram into about 2 minutes, so hear me out. You're so young. You've got your whole life ahead of you.
Sam.
But I've been there. I've done the big white wedding. And let me tell you, it doesn't always end up happy ever after. I still remember pleading with my wife. No more.
Thank you.
wanted to give you this.
I don't mean here, here. I mean here on the island.
Just please take it.
Holy shit, what's this?
I thought you might have had to tighten your belt a bit over the years, you know, looking after Sophie all on your own. I just wanted to contribute a small something to the wedding.
Harry? This would cover 4 weddings and a funeral. Oh, Harry, it's a lovely gesture, but...
You know the last time you said those words to me?
No.
It was when I bought you the guitar. I remember thinking, those are the last words I will ever hear from Donna. I will cherish them forever. Oh, Harry, it's a lovely gesture, but...
You just made that up. Sure, I said thank you kindly like a well-brought-up Catholic girl.
That's better. You know, I think that's the first time I've heard you laugh since I arrived.
I've been a bit stressed, Harry. What do you expect?
A bit more of the old Donna, less of the well-brought-up Catholic girl.
Yeah, it's stunning. So are Lisa and Allie ready to help you?
Will you help me, Mom?
Go with a sense of that well-known sadness.
business and raising a kid all on her own.
Didn't have much choice, did I? An unmarried mom in the 70s couldn't very well go home. My mother disowned me.
What? No.
It's a damn good thing, too. I'd rather be here with you than some depressing old housing project.
Sleeping our eyes, her and me, at the breakfast table. Barely awake, I let precious time go by. I watch her go with that old melancholy feeling. Endless questions I can't deny. What happened to
Sophie tells me that you're giving her away.
Of course I am. Who else?
How about her dad?
He's not here.
It's what she wants. She told me. She wants her dad to walk her down the aisle. Maybe her dad wants that too.
Don't do this now, Sam. I can't hear this now.
Don't listen. This is about us.
I don't want to talk about the things we've gone through, though it's hurting me. Played all my cards, and that's what you've done too. Nothing more to say. No more race to win. The winner takes it all. The loser standing small beside. Thank you.
a sheet.
I'm a writer. I made up my mind long ago. I walk a lone path.
If you change your mind, I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. I'm gonna be a if you've got no place to go when you're feeling down, give it all the love.
you, Sophie and Sky. Welcome to all your friends, and welcome especially to Donna, who represents your family. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here...
And welcome to Sophie's dad. I can't keep it from you any longer. I have to tell you, he is here.
I know. I invited him.
But you couldn't have. I don't know which one he is.
Which one?
Oh my God, that's why they're all here.
I'm really, really sorry, Mom. Will you ever forgive me?
Will you ever forgive me?
Oh, Mom. I don't care if you slept with hundreds of men.
With hundreds of men.
Hang on. Am I getting this straight? Sophie might be mine, but she might be Harry's? Or Bill's?
Yes, and don't you go getting all self-righteous about it. You have nobody but yourself to blame.
Yeah, if you had ditched my mom and gone off to marry some other woman.
Oh. It wasn't like that. I was engaged. I had to go back. But I came back to the island. I told Lorraine that I couldn't marry her, and I came back.
Why didn't you call me?
Because I was stupid enough to think that you'd be sitting in your room and pining for me. Only, when I arrived, they told me that you went off with some other guy. I went straight back home. Lorraine told me what an idiot I was and married me to prove it.
If I might just interject for a moment.
Harry? Check.
Oh, no, Donna, stop the check. It's yours. Donna, you're the first woman I ever loved. And you were also the last. I mean, there's all kinds of families, aren't there? Yours is you and Sophie, and mine is me and Nigel. I'm glad to have even a third of Sophie. It's more than I thought I'd ever get of a daughter.
Me too. I'm so glad I'm a third of Sophie.
Oh,
and me too.
Well, we could find out which one of you is my real dad. But I don't need to. And I think I've learned something about myself. Sky, let's not get married.
What?
I know none of this is what you wanted, and I've got my whole life ahead of me. So let's just get off the island and get at that world.
I love you.
Donna, do I take it this means the wedding is canceled?
I haven't got a clue what's going on.
Hang on. Hear me out. Why should we waste such a nice wedding? How about it, Sheridan? You're gonna need someone to boss around this island of yours.
Are you nuts? I'm not a bigamist.
Well, neither am I. I'm a divorced man that has loved you for 21 years. And ever since I got on this island, I've been bursting for your heart. Come on, Don. It's only the rest of our lives.
Do I?